beginning, we let them eat next to each other. Till we didn't need a fence. Milkshake had no fear at all.
The
next bit was a crucial moment in their relationship.
Watch it all the time, because if you turned your back on it and it got too hot, it would ruin all your work. So it was very laborious, the bones and it remained bristling fat. This is really good tasty beef. At this point, turn off your slow cooker and let it cool completely. As it cools, the fat on the top will solidify, making it very easy to remove. Once you're done with that, strain your broth and filter it through a piece of cloth to get out all the suckers. So go ahead and rinse out your slow cooker and return the clarified broth to it and turn it back on low. Let it go and leave the lid off. Let it cook for anywhere from 18 to 24 hours. What we're doing at this stage in the process is reducing the broth down to a gelatin. Gelatin is an interesting thing. Don't expect to be able to reduce this down into a hard block. What you end up with is a nice medium brown gooey substance. If you overcook it, you will burn it, giving it a very, very unpleasant taste. Once your soup reaches this stage, turn off your slow cooker and let it cool completely. Then you can turn the gel out onto a cloth. Now the soup is still very gelatinous. You get it to the point where you can store it, put it in your pocket. It needs to be dry. Now you cannot do this with heat. Any temperature of heat will just turn this into a liquid again, and then you'll just burn it. So it needs to be done without heat. You can do this in a dehydrator, but you need to make sure the dehydrator doesn't heat anything up. The period recipe actually suggests turning it out onto a rolling flannel cloth, just like we've done here, and flipping it over 2 or 3 times a day for 10 days or 2 weeks or so. You want to speed this process up at home, put this on a cooling rack and put it in front of a